Shalom viewers, welcome once again to this program. My name is Joyce W. Charles, coming to you from Oracle Television Network. We are going to be checking once again deep inside this book, which is called The Wonders of Dreams, The Hidden Wonders of Dreams. This is a powerful book that my father, the Oracle, has written. It is a book that is helping a lot of people even to be able to understand the world of dreams that is usually hidden to people. And I believe that God has anointed him to help you so that you're able to understand what is hidden in your dreams and what are your dreams pointing to. And this is a book you need to get yourself. It is only 1,000 shillings. And today we're gonna be continuing from where we stopped yesterday. And before we do that, I want to welcome you. If you're watching us on TV, you're welcome to just enjoy the program. I believe you're going to hear God through this. If you've been dreaming and you don't know what's happening and what's going on, I believe you're going to get a lot of understanding. Those of you who are watching us online, I want to encourage you to just go ahead and subscribe to our YouTube page. That is the Oracle Television Network. Those of you who are watching us on Facebook, like our page. Our Facebook page is called the Oracle Television Network. If you're watching us on any other platform online, thank you so much. Please share this program. Go ahead and just comment. We are going to reply to you because we want to communicate with you. We want to know that you're being a blessing to you. Let us know where you're watching us from so that we actually know how far we are reaching. God bless you once again for joining me. I believe it is an appointed time that God has for you. You didn't just tune in because it is another day, another program. You didn't just stumble on this show, on this program, just because you're searching channels and you got yourself here. Recently, I got a message from a woman who was not even watching our station, but the baby was just playing with the, with the remote, and all of a sudden, they stumbled on Oracle Television Network, and it's been a blessing to them. And so I believe you're not just stumbling to this station. God has got an appointment for you. And you will know so when you continue listening, because your deliverance is assured. Your blessings is something that you contact when you contact this channel. So The Hidden Wonders of Dreams is a book we are talking about. Now, we started by talking about the dreams that come from God. It's all here. By the way, all the things that I'm talking about, they're from this book. And I'm not talking about everything. It's just bits and bits of it so that you know what is happening in here. And so that even when you get this book, it is going to be easier for you to be able to know where you fit in and what goes on in your life when it comes to dreaming. Some of you who've been dreaming a lot of dreams, like possibly you start dreaming, you're always in the village, you dream, you're doing your exam, and you're always doing your exam and not finishing. You dream running. Sometimes you dream eating food in a dream. You dream being chased by animals. You dream, being chased by snakes. You dream, or you hear voices. All those things are in this book and much more. I cannot possibly do this in one show, but I want to assure you, for 1,000 shillings, you're going to get the knowledge that is going to help you understand the hidden wonders of dreams. Now, let us look at the book of Genesis chapter number. We're going to be looking at the book of Genesis, and that is going to be chapter number 20 and verses number 3. Genesis 23. Genesis chapter number 20 and verses and number 3 says, Genesis 20 and verses number 3 is the story of a dream that God gave to Abimelech. And the Bible says, but God said to Abimelech in a dream by night and said to him, behold, you at but a dead man, for the woman which you have taken, for she is a man's wife. In other words, God is telling Abimelech that you are a dead man because the woman that you have taken, who is Sarah, she is Abraham's wife. That is basically what the scripture is talking about here. So it says, but God said unto Abimelech in a dream by night and said to him, behold, thou art a dead man, for the woman which you have taken, for she is a man's wife. So this is a godly dream, and God is talking to Abimelech and telling him, I can see you have taken somebody's wife and you are a dead man because you have done the wrong thing. What am I saying by reading that verse of scripture? It is because we are talking about godly dreams, and How do you identify dreams that are godly? Now, one of the things that you're going to identify if your dreams are godly, number one, you see, we can only know God was speaking to Abimelech because the dream is pointing him to not doing the wrong thing. In other words, when a dream that you have has come from God, it will point you to the scriptures. It is going to be accurate with the scriptures. There is no way a dream can come to you from God and is going to encourage you to have somebody's wife. That is not God. God will never encourage you through a dream to do something ungodly, to do something demonic, to do something that is not right and not aligned with his word. So number one thing that helps you know that the dream that you have is coming from God, it is when it is aligning with the scriptures. It is accurate with the scriptures. It is not just another dream that causes you to do things that are ungodly. And so you are able to analyze and know if this dream has come from God. And I know I'm talking to people who have been dreaming and you possibly don't know whether the dream has come from God. You have to check the word of God. Is what you're getting in the dream connecting with the word, aligning with the word, agreeing with the word, accurate with the word of God? If there is no accuracy of the word of God, then definitely you are hearing from other sources. There is no way God is going to tell you in a dream to take something that is not yours, that is called stealing. There is no way God will tell you in a dream to break a child's touch. That is not God. There is no way God will tell you in a dream that he has ordained to do something wrong to somebody. That cannot be God. So God is love. You know, God is pure. So anything that is not in the will of God, it cannot be from God. And then whenever you are dreaming and you want to know that that dream is from God, always check the dream mood. The dream mood is the feeling that comes with the dream. The feeling that comes with the dream. Most of the time when you are dreaming, there is always that feeling that you have. You can remember when you were dreaming, you had such a specific feeling that you had. When you're dreaming, you had some specific feeling. Now, if what you're feeling when you dream, it is not pure and it cannot be from God. For example, if you have a dream about somebody and what you feel in that dream is hatred, is jealousy, and it cannot be from God. The mood of the dream has to be pure. The mood of the dream will bring you good, godly feelings or the desire that are going to be part in the dream. For example, if you dream, you know, if you dream you're talking to somebody and all of a sudden your desire is just that you don't want to be this near this person and they have not done anything wrong. Possibly they're your pastor or possibly they're your wife or your husband and this is somebody you should be close to. You should desire them. You should be around them. So if the dream is coming to you and you hate your pastor, you hate your wife, you hate your spouse, you hate your children, you don't have any desire, you don't want anything to do with them, that can never be God, because the mood of the dream that is godly will always bring that, you know, that good feeling about somebody. Even when you dream concerning your drunk brother, you love them, you don't hate them. Even when you dream about that wicked heathen that is getting lost, you just have that heart of God that loves sinners. Then you know that is coming from God. So the mood of the dream is very, very important. All these things are here. Please get this book and it's going to be a blessing to you, and you're not gonna be in a place you do not understand dreams. The other thing that you're going to look at when you're talking about dreams, you're going to see that the dreams are pushing you to God. They are directing you to God. Let us look at the book of Revelation. Revelation 19 and verses number 10. Revelation 19:10 says, "And I fell at the feet to worship him. And he said unto me, See, thou do it not. I am thy fellow servant, and of your brethren that have the testimony of Jesus. Worship God, for the testimony of Jesus is a spirit of prophecy." Let me begin again. That is Revelation 19:10. "And I fell to his feet to worship him. And he said unto me, See, thou do it not. I am thy fellow servant, And of thy brethren that have testimony of Jesus, worship God. For the testimony of Jesus is a spirit of prophecy. You know, dreams is classified as part of the ways that the Holy Spirit speaks. And when we're talking about the voice of the Spirit, we basically are talking about prophecy. But just because you're dreaming doesn't mean you're a prophet. Just because you're hearing from the Spirit of God doesn't mean that you're a prophet. But now, the book of Revelation is telling us that the spirit of prophecy is in the testimony of Jesus. So whenever a dream is directing you to God, it wants you, the dream is pushing you to God, you know, loving God, worshiping Him, everything about God, serving Him, giving to the work of the Lord, loving God's people, supporting the work of God, reading God's word, connecting with the right people. If that is where the dream is pushing you, then basically that is God, because the Bible is telling us in the book of Revelation that the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. So the spirit behind dreaming, if it is godly dream, then it's going to point you to Jesus. So whatever you're dreaming, if it is godly, it will point you to Jesus. How do I know that? It will point you to loving the things that Jesus loves. It will point you to doing the things that Jesus would want you to do. It will point you to desiring the things that Jesus would want you to desire. So the spirit of prophecy will always be Jesus. So if the dream is not connecting you to Jesus, if the dream is not connecting you to the things of God, then definitely the dream is not godly. So that is one of the things that you look at when it comes to godly dream. It will always connect you and point you to Jesus Christ. When you look at the book of Galatians chapter number 5, let us begin reading from verses number 18. But if you are led of the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanliness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envies, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and the like, of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in times past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. So those are the works of the flesh. But, verses 22, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. Now, so when you're looking at the fruit of the dream, what do I mean by the fruit of the dream? I mean, once you have dreamt, the dream, the fruit of it is the outcome of it, right? The fruit is the outcome. Remember, for you to get a fruit, there must be a plant that really got to the level of getting a fruit. So the fruit is the outcome of this dream. After you have dreamt, what is the outcome? Have you dreamt and then all of a sudden things are not going well the way you are living, you know, in righteousness? All of a sudden you are desiring, you know, to have one for the road. You're desiring to smoke. If that is the end of the dream, for example, if you're just sleeping and you have a dream and when you wake up in the morning, you just have a desire, you know, to smoke. Something went very wrong in the dream because a seed was planted that is taking you back to where you came from. If possibly you are dreaming, maybe eating food in the dream, and when you wake up in the morning, the first thing you want to do is light a cigarette, is get a glass of wine and drink, then basically, through witchcraft, you have been bewitched and you're going back to the things of the world. So the fruit of this dream that you dreamt, whether it had meaning according to you or it didn't, but we see the fruit. For example, there are so many people who cannot explain why they are the way they are, why they are suffering the things they are suffering. Now, if you want to know if it is God who visits you in the dream, you are going to look at your life. What are you seeing in your life? Are you seeing the acts of the flesh? We have read here, is adultery, is fornication, drunkenness, witchcraft. If you dream and you remember or you don't remember, but when you wake up the following morning, you so much dislike people that you just want to curse them, then obviously whatever is going on in your dreams, it can never be God. Because when you are hearing through dreams from God, you are going to have long suffering. No matter what people have done against you, you're just going to have that heart that says, let me give them a chance. Let me forgive them. That is the kind of heart you're going to have. You're not just going to curse people just because possibly they said something to you. You're not just going to bewitch people just because you don't like them. If that is the things that you're busy with, it means that even in your dreams, the enemy has really invaded and planted the seeds of unrighteousness, the seeds of the flesh in your life. I know we have got so many dreamers who dreams, and if you look at the work in their life, the works that are in their life, it is basically very demonic. In other words, it is very easy to know who has taken over your dreams. If you're living a life where we can see the fruit of the Spirit, and we have seen the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance. If that is what your daily life is about, when you're dealing with people, when you're working, when you're serving God, if that is the fruit of the Spirit we are seeing, then your dreams are very clearly from God. But if we look at you and you're just seeing the works of the flesh, that even in your dream, you are not hearing from God. I'll tell you why. Because the things that happen at night are going to manifest or bear fruit during the day. So there is no way you can be hearing from God. And when you wake up in the morning, you are a hate monger. You just hate people. That can never be God. It is not possible that you tell us you're hearing from God. But when you do your daily work, when you're relating with your colleagues, you're just a quarrelsome person. You hate everybody. You despise everybody. You backbite. It can never be God. So there are things you have to look at. Are you having the voice of God? He will guide you into righteousness. He will guide you into godliness. So I want you to understand, this book is able to guide you into hearing from God, into knowing what God is saying concerning dreams. Sometimes we get very confused and we think God is talking. We make very serious decisions and God is not talking. We make very serious, you know, statements. We speak to people very serious things and we think it is God, but it is not God. It is important for you to understand dreams that are coming from God, because it is God's voice that will let us know where we are going. Remember, the Bible says in the book of Jeremiah that the plans I have for you, they are good, to give you a hope and a future. So if you have a future that God has about you and you don't know, by dreams, God is able to reveal to you so that you're walking in the ways that are godly. And I pray for you, my viewers, today, in the mighty name of the Lord, that the line of communication between you and God is going to open. I'm reading this book and it says, God communicates to men through dreams. God communicates to men through dreams. So if you are one of those who says you don't hear God, if you're one of those who goes to seek prophets because you cannot hear God by yourself, I pray for you today that your dream lines are going to open and you're going to hear God. And as you get yourself this book, as you buy this book for only 1,000, I believe your dream lines are going to open. Understanding of how God speaks is going to be open before you. And dreams are going to be a walk in the park. You're going to understand what is happening in your life. Now, this book is hard work that my father has done. And he's been able to compile this from all the years he's walked with God. All the years he's walked with God, over 30 years of walking with God, has given him the grace and the ability and the know-how to write this book. So you don't have to go do all hard work. You just need to get it, and you're going to understand things that you may not be able to understand through usual, you know, encounters or through usual dreams. But when you read this book, you are able to know what is happening in your life. And so I want to believe that you've been blessed and that you're going to know God wants to speak to you through dreams. Are you positioned enough to hear him? Are you positioned enough to know what he's saying? Are you positioned enough to listen and obey him through what he has said in dreams? When God said what we have read to Abimelech, that is the book of Genesis chapter number 20, he gave back the wife of Abraham. And so when God speaks to you in a dream, he's expecting you to honor him. He's expecting you to obey him. He's expecting you to do what he has said in a dream. And every time God talks to you in a dream and you are not following it up, you are not doing what he said, the most likely thing to happen is the dream line is going not to work again. I've seen people who can tell you, I used to dream, but I do not dream again. It is because if you're hearing from God and you didn't obey what he was telling you to do in a dream, then you automatically lose that dream line. There is no reason why. If you call somebody and you speak to them and they do not speak back, do you think you're going to continue talking to them? You don't, because they have got no interest of talking to you. All you need to do is repent, go back to God, tell God, I've lost your voice. Some of it is because of bewitchment. I have seen people who clearly hear God, but because the devil knows how powerful the dream lines are, he will make sure that you don't hear God anymore. And he will interfere and interject in your dream lines and plant seeds that are demonic. You find all of a sudden you used to hear from God through dreams, you're no longer hearing. You're dreaming dreams that are very demonic. Now I pray for you, my viewers, in Jesus' name. Those of you who used to hear God through dreams and you no longer hear him, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I pray that your dream lines are going to open. I break each and every power of witchcraft that says you cannot hear God. Each and every demonic seed that has been planted against you hearing God, right now I uproot it. I uproot each and every demonic plantation that has been planted that you cannot hear God. I decree and I declare, by the anointing and the grace of my Father, the Oracle, your dream lines are opening now. Your dream lines are opening now to hear God. In Jesus' name, I pray for you and I bless you today. Now you call the numbers that are on the screen. Call us. Let us know how many copies we should send to you. Wherever you are, in Kenya, outside Kenya, this book can be sent to you at a very small fee. So, do not say I'm not in Nakuru. These books have gone in America. They have gone in Germany. They have gone all over the world, in Australia. We have sent basically this book in every continent. There is no continent in the world that these books are not going to. So just give us a call. Write us a message. Write a comment on Facebook and we are going to get back to you. Write a comment on YouTube and we are going to answer you. God bless you so much as you order this book and your life will never be the same again. Thank you so much for tuning in. We are going to continue. We've only been looking at dreams that comes from God. We're going to continue with the dreams that come from your flesh. Those dreams that are fleshly. We're going to continue and see which are these dreams. Are you hearing yourself thinking it is God? And this is going to be a good program that is coming up about dreams that are coming from your flesh. From there, we're going to continue with the dreams that are coming from the devil. And from there, we're going to deal with all the things that are in this book, portion by portion. And God is going to bless us even as we do that. Thank you so much. God bless you.